Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophynut and welcome back to Bioshock 2 in our Let's Replay series, where we try to delve a bit deeper into the story and the backside of this game. So, last time, if you remember, the game crashed on me during the gather here on the upper balcony of the theater. And in the meantime, I've worked my way back up, so pretty much everything should be the same. So I'm gonna gather this this corpse again. Here you go. Try not to get killed. I'm gonna try and put myself in a better position this time. Maybe I should. Yeah, I'm gonna put myself on the seats here, giving myself a better position. So I hear spider splicers coming. Okay. There we go. The rivet gun is doing its work. Headshots, please. This one is dead. There we go. That's pretty much everything there is, apparently. No. There's one more. Don't know what's happening to the scene. There he goes. I hear more footsteps. Hello? I got one more rivet for anyone who comes through that door, seriously. Anyone? No? Okay, how the hell did you guys get through that cyclo trap? Let's pick her up. I think there's another... No? Oh, he's down there. There we go, more first aid kits. Let's loot this place a bit. Seems like the spider splicer didn't decide to come up. Thank you very much. Proximity mines. Oh, I could have used those, of course. Didn't do that this time. More rivets, always handy, because we spent most of those on this gather. Thank you very much. Yeah, okay. Okay, we're done. And now there's a very, very handy sign pointing us towards the projection booth. So that's probably something we should check out. Over here, and then over there. Sounds like there's a camera over there. I'm not really sure if I completely researched security right now. So let's go with Electropult. Oh, that was a turret. That was... God damn it. There we go. Can I pick that back up? Oh, I can. Oh no. That was amazing. There was a mini turret behind the turret I just put down. That was embarrassing. Never mind. Audio diary. Growing up.
The little sisters are getting older, which is troubling. As they reach adolescence, they become aggressive, feral. Worse, the atom they ingest contains traces of lethal plasmids left over from the war. The splicers are becoming far more effective predators as well. Our big daddies are falling left and right. Perhaps the elder sisters could be trained to sniff out the lost atom and reclaim it for us. Yes, from what I've seen, they certainly wouldn't have to wait for the culprit to die.
Yeah, because as we've seen, they can pull Adam from a living person as well. So that's very interesting. The little sisters became a lot more aggressive when they grew older because, well, largely because of the Adam in their bodies. And they also developed some plasmids that were left over in the Adam that they found, which made them very efficient killing machines. As we've experienced already. Heavy rivet trap. Ooh. There's a lot of nice stuff here. Anything else? Search the cabinet. Shotgun ammo. Oh! I wanted to try again, but yeah, okay, there we go. And there's gin underneath the desk. Whoever this guy was, he was drinking on the job. I can hear a splicer, but I think the mini turret should take care of that. That wasn't a projection boot. I think this is. Anything in between here? An ammo bandito. Should I hack this? Maybe I should. Even for the extra items, that's always very nice. Extra ammo, and it's another frag grenade. Two, actually. Two frag grenades. Look at this. I don't... Don't know about you guys, but this does look suspicious. Okay. You're dead. You're dead as well. So what happened here? What? Okay. So the camera triggered those, well, the splices over in the hallway triggered the camera. Seems like this thing is not really working anymore. But this, extended reel. Get to know your enemies a little better. With extended reel, you'll get much more quality time with each research target. Research sessions last a bit longer. Now, I found this really, really weird that it's right here, because it's really late in the game. By now, we researched pretty much everything there is to research. I think we're still missing a bit on the brood splicer, a bit on big daddies, and a bit on big sisters, and a bit on securities. But that's pretty much it. Okay. She's dead. Anybody else? Thank you very much for your patronage. And we'll get back to the... What was that? What the... I hear footsteps and my indicator turned red for a second there. Ow. Ow. There he goes, in the face. Should work out great. Because these are solid slugs, so they should do more damage to soft targets. Let's see. So I think that does it for the... Okay. That does it for the theater. Houdini spices, right. I didn't... Oh, for fuck's sake. That is really, really annoying. That was actually a lie. Oh, hi. Bye. The shotgun packs a bit of a punch. Hello? Because that was a female one and the other one was male. Not that I'm, where does this go? Oh! Hi! Are you Houdini splicers by any chance? I think, yeah, they are. So that means... Hi! That was a nice touch. Goodbye! Any of you still alive? It appears they're not alive anymore. I am so sorry for those two, no, I'm not sorry. I'm not sorry about those frag grenades. I just like to, party crash like that. There's more stuff down here. Kinda reminds me of the Fighting McDonough bar in, from the original game. Yeah, because it's really, really similar with the same kind of windows. Huh, interesting. The other thing I wanted to talk about, I already mentioned that the original plan from the developers for Dionysus Park was that they wanted to make this the most pristine level in the game, but they changed that to accommodate for the story that this place was flooded and most of the people here were killed in some sort of horrid accident. You already noticed the similarities with this level and Fort Frolic from the previous game. That is because they originally planned to let this level start out in Fort Frolic. So the main atrium, the main room from Fort Frolic would be reused in this game. And they would let the players go through that to have a bit of a familiar sight to start this level off with. Because this would be an extension of Fort Frolic. Phosphorus bug, always handy. And more stuff in the cabinets, thank you very much. Learning poker.
You must learn to play poker, Eleanor. Like anyone, I am flawed and have a fierce genetic bias towards competition. But each Saturday, I read the other players, and I pick a man who will benefit the most from victory. By the final hand, I ensure that he takes home my entire stake and that of the others. I win nothing but the feeling of conquest over myself and the wealth of my competitors. Is slowly reshuffled according to their needs.
So, another indication of how manipulative that lamb actually is. She really liked to play poker, and she wanted Eleanor to learn that as well, because it's a valid life lesson, according to her at least. Let's see, so that's, I think, is everything for the theater, although, of course, there's one more gather here down the theater, and now that we killed all of the splicers, that might actually not be such a bad idea. I think if I go for anti-personnel rounds, that should be fine. I'm not really able to set up a lot of traps, maybe a few cyclone traps. There we go, and I think there's one left. And let's get this party started then. Anti-personnel rounds and gather Adam. Maybe I should even...
I've got nothing for you.
You've got nothing for me? Did that come from over here? That was... Oh, hi. That's like skeet shooting. Oh, hi. Yeah, if you... Yep, hi. Ow. Nope, you should not. Buffoon? I'm not a buffoon. Hi. What's happening with the... What the... Did that just move? That was... Did the curtain just go up? Because of the... That was interesting. Never saw that happen before. Kind of had a bit of trouble with those, but... Yeah, I think that went pretty good, all things considered. Let's take that, because that's another health kit for me. More Eve hypos. Any more health kits? This place is starting to creep me out with all the music and the stuff happening around here. More spider splicers. Don't drop any health kits. Oh, there we go, another health kit. Is there a little sister vent in this place? Wait, it's just a dead end? That was interesting. I thought that looped around. This guy's still hanging around. Kinda got an upside down noose on his feet. Anything I can get from here? No. Oh, and there's the vent. Okay, that's good. So that's only my second little sister, if I'm not mistaken. So this should trigger another of the Adam memories. So let's rescue her. Here you go, girl. Back in your hole in the wall. You don't need to make a funny face about that. There we go.
That's me there. I confronted Stanley. Said I'd tell Mother what he had done. He panicked. Took me away and sold me to an orphanage. I tried to fight back. I remember biting his hand, but... Father, he's the reason I was turned into a little sister.
So that's something we already thought about. We already suspected. That Stanley was the reason that Eleanor was turned into a little sister. So Eleanor confronted him about his actions in Dionysus Park in Sophia Lambs' absence, and that caused Stanley to start panicking.
Now, you were just a deep sea explorer with iron cojones, pal. The public gave it a nickname. But Ryan was sure you were a spook. So his people locked you up. Erased your damn name. Goodbye, Johnny Topside. Hello, Subject Delta.
So Ryan erased our name because he thought we were a CIA spook, a bit like how that happened in the main game. Goodbye. Because he dropped his grenade.
When all this is over and we're divvying up Rapture's bounty, you and I'll be holding court on a private island, son. Think of it. Each world power on bended knee, holding a bouquet made of money.
So there we go, a bit more about Sinclair's motive. He wants to sell
the
all the...
The girl you've saved from Mother want to thank you. Check the Gatherer's Garden.
Am I that close to the Gatherer's Garden? Is that around the corner here, maybe? Why? I don't see where I need to be, but never mind. So Sinclair, as he mentioned before, wants to sell all the ideas from Rapture and sell them as his own and make a lot of money and power in the real world, the world up, well, on the mainland, not under the sea. Not that this is fake, of course. Well, it is fake, it's a video game, but it's really, really nicely done. Don't really need to be here. I wonder where the Gatherer's Garden is. Can't really put my finger on there right now. So let's use the pieces. Let's take this with us. I always like to start conversations off with a big bang. That was, yeah, that I'm gonna shut up now. Hi, my name is Trophonet, and hello! Oh, that was, sorry. Oh. Nope, don't hit me. I'm starting to need a lot of ammo to get rid of these splicers. I'm actually wondering, can I buy a few things? Because kind of low on rivets and on drill fuel. So let's buy a few of those. Anti-personnel rounds. There we go. That should do it. Okay, so we need to go back to the main area with the carousel. And yeah, that's where the Gatherer's Garden is as well. What was that noise? Whoa! Hello! Thank you very much. Don't really need all that trouble though. Is the music still playing? Because that was a bit of annoying. Oh, hello. There it is. Hello. Thank you very much. Demanding father, $75 and 120 Adam. If your little helpers keep getting interrupted while gathering, tell them to get a move on with our demanding father tonic. Little sisters gather Adam more quickly. I kind of like that, but I don't know if that limits the amount of enemies that will spawn on the gatherer. But I do want to switch that out for Scrounger. Yeah, there we go. Thank you very much. So that's 540 Adam. What the hell is going on? What's that noise? Never mind. Let's purchase some stuff. The upgrades wouldn't actually be that bad. Ooh, but this is really nice. Cyclone Trap 3. Place traps on walls and ceilings. I think I'm going to use that. Drill Lurker. Increases damage from melee attacks on unaware opponents, especially from the drill swing. Hacking success zones become a little bit larger. That would also be very nice. But let's start it off with a health upgrade and an Eve upgrade. Then we're gonna get Cyclone Trap 3.
Place traps on any surface. Create more elaborate booby traps. The possibilities are endless.
Yes, they are, because now we can bounce splices around if we want to. Insect swarm would actually be really, really nice. But do I want to get that now? I'm going to buy another gene tonic. Let's put Cure All there for now. I do have a lot of interesting gene tonics. Maybe I should just put Goose Hound there, buy another slot. And then we're going to get EZ. Easy hack, of course. Easy hack. I'm such a dumbass. Easy hack. Let's put that instead of cure all, and then I think I'm gonna just take drill lurker. Drill lurker is always funny. There we go. And then the lower row, I'm gonna keep that for a rainy day. So the other thing I'm gonna do is buy another. I'm gonna go for another plasmid slot. I could put Hypnotize there for now, though we need to rest. But Insect Swarm, there we go. That's gonna come in really handy.
Summon a swarm of insects. Laugh as they seek out hidden enemies.
There we go. Simple as that. I don't have enough Adam yet to buy the upgrade for that. But I think I'm gonna just upgrade my Eve again. There we go. Bees, the bee's knees, and not the bee's knees. Let's check out where the last area. True Cohen's collection? Is that right? Oh yeah, I think that's right, because I accidentally tried to enter that area when I replayed this. I hear the Big Daddy, but... where? Oh! Wait a second. This isn't... right, because the arrow even points me in the other direction. Why is there a Big Daddy here? Because these are the areas where we came from. Give me a second. So I think it's this door right next to the Gatherer's Garden, right? Because I hear the Big Daddy through. Yeah, there we go. Although you're damaged and you don't have a little sister with you. Because, yeah, we saw the little sister on the other side of the level, but I think... ooh, Eve Expert. Sometimes you need a little extra in your pocket to get you through these troubled times. Stock up on Eve Hypos for extended plasmid use with Eve Expert. So that just allows you to carry one more Eve Hypo. I'm not gonna do that. Dionysus Spark's weakness.
McDonough, listen. There's a hell of a structural flaw here in Dionysus Park. A leak in the primary drainage pipeline could flood this whole joint. Faulty pressure locks would seal in every sorry soul. One clumsy Big Daddy knocks open the wrong pipe and, hey presto, Lamb's little art show turns into Fish City. God forbid the wrong element finds out.
There we go, and the wrong element did find out, because Big Kate O'Malley is the woman we heard. I think that was actually the first audio diary that pointed us towards Electrobolt. And she says that, hitting the wrong pipe will lock everybody in and kill everybody inside of this area. Lamb's Garden, I don't think we've been here before. Yeah, and this is where the next little sister is supposed to be, but... for some reason, it's not here. Or is it? Oh, it is. Let's get you... ooh, that's actually interesting. I'm gonna put a trap over here, charge it with Electrobolt, take a picture, and then get some rocket spears ready. And there we go. Oh shit. Gather that up. Okay, and now get with the shotgun. Oh, what? I think, holy shit. This guy's mad with me as well. Arms race. Tired of constantly scrounging for ammo, arms race help you find those extra rounds you'd otherwise miss. You're able to salvage more ammunition from bodies and containers. Is that interesting or not? Keen Observer. Am I losing the touch of that? I'm gonna wait for now. I just killed two Big Daddies. Wow, that was interesting. Thank you for that, and thank you for that. Two rocket spears back, and let's grab you.
You always save me from monsters.
I'm wondering, if I die and you start crying next to my corpse, are you gonna change around that fast as well? Because we're gonna have a little talk otherwise. Because unlike these guys, I come back. Right now, where else do we need to go? So there's a body right here. Which is actually not that bad of an idea. If I hack this health station... ooh, and you can actually see that those areas are a lot bigger than they were before. I like my new plasmid. Tonic. Let's take that. What else is in here? We can go up here. More proximity mines. So that might actually not be a bad idea. Put down a few proximity mines along with the traps. Saving our little sister. Okay, there we go. Just normal shotgun bullets. Not that great, are they? Let's get rivets and that one. There's always one heavy rivet in these things. Don't really know why. Is that because I hacked it? One of the heavy rivets fell through out of the... actually, one thing. If I put... I'm gonna put a trap here. Yeah, thank you very much. Let's charge that up. Quickly buy an Eve Hypo. And maybe one more in the middle here. There we go. I think I'm actually going to use the grenade launcher as my weapon at the moment. So, gather Adam. Here we go again. Probably for the last time this episode. Is there someone over there? I think I heard someone over there. I don't think this door opens. Oh, that was nice. There we go. Good surprise. There we go, and I think, wow.
Come on, Daddy.
You were done really, really quickly. Let's gather you up then.
I'm always safe with Daddy.
Come along with me. Can I pick that back up? That's really, really nice, because previously you couldn't do that in Bioshock, the original Bioshock. You couldn't pick up your proximity mines if you dropped them down. So that was a bit of a problem there. So you needed to really, really think about where to put your proximity mines. But right over here, it's very, very interesting that you can pick those right back up. Same with the, well, not the mini turrets. That was a bad choice. The mini turrets. Ooh, armor piercing rounds. Where did those come from? Pick up my proximity mine again, and then probably shoot a splice from the
field. Daddy's giving you stars and birdies.
Stars and birdies. Not really sure what those are, but I'm gonna give them to you. Okay, so we only need one more gather, and then we should be done with this area. So I'm going to take a little break, and when we get back, we're going to finish off Dionysus Park. But thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!